Hello everyone and welcome back to the United Star. We've got Mananveer Singh here with us, who is an absolute talent. He's a fantastic singer and he's got a couple of songs released with Zee Music Company. He's also got his own YouTube channel where there are a couple of songs. He's releasing more songs. He's in the process of releasing them. So he's a huge Man United fan, of course, that's why he's here. But also do check out his Instagram, his YouTube and support him. Whatever love we can show the Manchester United community and fan base, it's always good. We've also got Vishesh here with us. He's back after a few videos. Vishesh, good to have you back as well. Today, we're going to do a short review of how the season has been till now. The first sort of Carabao Cup games and the Premier League games and where we go from here. The transfer drama is behind us and now all that's in front of us is football. We don't have to worry about things that are happening off the field. Now, for today, we're going to focus on what's going on it. So, Manan, let me bring you straight in. What have you seen in these games that sort of worries you, or what is it down that we played quite poorly, to be honest?
First of all, thanks for having me on United Star. It's a pleasure to be here. Thanks for all the great introduction you've given me. I think season so far, the first couple of matches that I saw against Crystal Palace and Brighton, I thought that we were lacking the sharpness, even a front five. In first match against Crystal Palace, they were nowhere seen. And in the second match against Brighton, they were getting back to their fitness. But then again, I feel that our defense have been a massive drawback this season. I mean, I think even against Spurs, the way we started the first goal, I think our front line, the front five, were supposed to have a great game if our defenders didn't already kill the game in the fifth minute. I mean, I think conceding immediately after you've scored and then conceding again, I mean, 8 minutes and it's 2-1, I think defense has let our whole team down. And that, for me, has been the biggest reason to worry about this team in this season and the how this team is going to proceed in this season. I've never had a doubt about our attacks. I've had a doubt about our depth, which I think right now has been sorted out temporarily. But then attack has always been fantastic, but we have been let down by our defense.
I think, you know, Manan, you raise a very valid point. Vishesh, this is what I want to ask you. 3 goals against Palace, 2 goals against Brighton, let's not even talk about Spurs, 6 goals against Tottenham Hotspurs. If we were playing Brighton on another day and if the goalpost, as Ollie said, was a little smaller or whatever, bigger, we would have ended up conceding a lot more goals. So, Vishesh, in the defense, we've said Lindelof is a problem. But is it time we start looking at Harry Maguire, Luke Shaw and Aaron Wan-Bissaka as well?
Ashram, that's what I was going to come to when Manan said it. You know, Gary Neville comes out and says we need a partner for Maguire. Why don't we look at Evra when Evra is saying that, why not drop Maguire as a whole? I mean, he's not club captain material. When Martial got the red card, I didn't see him running to the ref and going in the face and being like, you know, Lamela did the same thing. Why aren't you looking at that? He was standing on the side. And the amount of mistakes he's making, I don't know what's happened to him since Greece. But if his mind is still there, please don't come on the pitch. I rather have two young defenders who are inexperienced but want to play and prove a point to the manager rather than defenders who just, you know, when they get the chance, they lose it. Because if we remember for the Spurs game, all of us were like, Eric Bailly has to play. He has to start. He got the opportunity. He didn't grab on it. In fact, he showed that Lindelof should have started instead. He was that dismayed. So, I mean, when you're giving them the opportunity, they're not performing. Luke Shaw, great after lockdown. I don't know what's happened to him. All he's doing is coming out and saying, we need new players. Yeah, we got a new player in your position. Now what? Why weren't you fighting for the badge? Aaron Wan-Bissaka is focusing way too much on the attacking front that he's forgotten his defensive capabilities. But you know what is surprising is this is the same defense that had the most clean sheets last season in all of Europe. And as you mentioned, in the last 3 games has conceded more than 11. I mean, has conceded 11 goals in the Premier League, which is just, you know,
could have been more.
Yeah, could have been more. Could have been more taking the Brighton game and the woodwork not being there. What I don't understand is if De Gea doesn't make a mistake, our defense is shit. And if our defense is good, De Gea has to make a mistake. Can we ever have both of them together? Please.
Yeah, that's another important point you raise is that Manan, David De Gea has not done anything wrong. In fact, in the three games, David De Gea has been very vocal. I just saw a video where he's shouting at Luke Shaw when he's gone away for the second goal or the third goal. He's saying, no, Luke, no, Luke, no, and he's running. Luke Shaw is not listening. So now Manan, my question is, are we not tactically set up right, or is the player's head just not there?
I think players' heads are not there, because I think there's been a lot of negativity in the dressing room, especially after the Spurs game. I think even before that, players' minds are not there. Because the kind of performance that makes you to believe that, okay, yaar, ye aisa sapne mein bhi nahi khel sakta. I think they're doing it on purpose. The kind of performance that led us to believe something like that, ki shit man, are they doing this on purpose? Because they are not that bad. We have seen those kind of performances. So I think Eric Bailly, other than giving away the ball for the third goal that he did, I think he made a couple of good recovery tackles. I think he made a couple of good blocks. But then after that, agar koi, there's no support. Luke Shaw... I think Luke Shaw has been one of the most pressured guys on the left wing, because we don't have a backup for it. Because if he is sick, we have Brandon Williams, which is clearly a right back material, but you're playing him on the left, who doesn't know how to defend, can go forward, but then he always leaves his flank empty. Then Aaron Wan-Bissaka, I think the reason he was phenomenal last season was because he used to practice on his defending more than attacking. But then recently he has been also pressured to improve his attacking game as well, which is not a bad thing. But then I think he's not a right wing back. He's just a right back. He's a proper traditional right back. He's not a right wing back. I mean, you don't see a traditional right back going and concentrating more on crosses than he's doing on defending. Yeah. And Aaron Wan-Bissaka has
Manan,
been
let me just come in here one second. What I want to say is, you're exactly right. My problem is this: against Palace, against Brighton, against Spurs, why did we get opened up? Is that the wingbacks are like our fullbacks are tucking in as wingbacks, and we're expecting Matic to drop back and three in defense to do their job. This is tactically not working. Teams have figured this out, and now they're playing through the channels. And the way Harry Kane was dropping off, because Matic is leaving that place open for to fall back in defense. So that midfield place is open. So Kane drops off and they come between the channels and they get the goals. The teams have figured us out.
Exactly.
So Vishesh, now I want to come to you. Why I asked Manan that, is it a tactical issue or a mentality issue? What do you think? Do we need to work this out tactically as well a little bit?
It's a mix of both, Prasham. When you look at it, Ole is one-dimensional, and we've spoken about it. We went down to 10 men, and for some reason, we were still trying to play from the back, even though we had so much press. And all teams know that's the way to go about it. But I think the mentality is also a big issue at the club right now. I think now we can move on to that segment if you want, but before the deadline, all players could have been under the mentality, you know, all clubs are strengthening, we're still the same, we've only got Van de Beek, we need more players. Players were coming out and saying it vocally that we need more players. Now they've got the players. It may not be what we wanted them to be, but we have got a bunch of 4-5 players. So now if players come out and say, you know, we didn't get anyone, they don't have any excuses. They didn't have it. You look at the excuse pile. Okay, we didn't have preseason. Fine. We give you four games for preseason. Okay, we didn't get players in. Fine. Okay, we got some players in. Maybe you want them. Maybe you don't want them. Your personal opinion. What's your excuse now? And you look at mentality. I'm done with this club, Prasham, because I remember after the Crystal Palace game, all the players coming on their Instagram and being like, you know, this is not what the fans deserve. We will always fight more for the club. The badge means a lot to us. And then they do the same against Spurs. So, I mean, if it meant so much at that time, what happened to you during the Spurs game?
Right. You know, Vishesh, you've raised a good point about mentality. And I think it's a very valid point. But we've said that time and again. I want to come back to the tactics, because what I said about the wing-backs tucking in is one problem. About Maguire making so many mistakes is another problem. I want to move a step forward and go into a midfield. Now, in a midfield, again, I want to bring up, like, tactically what I see the problem is, maybe. I see that Matic is falling into the three and Pogba is not doing his job of covering for him. We've seen in all the games that Pogba is not running at all. He just stands and he slowly, slowly passes. He ambles around in midfield. That intensity, that aggression is not there. So Manan, what do you think? How do we solve that problem? Do you take Pogba out of the team and put Fred in, or do you put Van de Beek in? How do you solve that problem?
Look, I'm really sorry to say, but all the hype that has been there about Pogba, I think that has just made him one of the most overrated players in our team. I don't know. Our manager doesn't have the guts to bench him when he's fit, even though he's not doing anything for the team. I wouldn't place Van de Beek instead of Pogba because clearly Van de Beek either plays at number 8 or number 10 role. You cannot expect Van de Beek to go there in a defensive midfield position. He either needs to be side by side to Fernandes, or he needs to be at the place of Fernandes. But you cannot expect Van de Beek to be there where Pogba plays, you know, right beside Matic. I think you have to change a bit of formations in your midfield. It's not necessary that you have to play a two defensive midfielders and then again aage aapka ek attacking midfielder khel raha hai. This thing, this 4-2-3 like 4-2-3 and then one, I think United need to switch from this, because when we had a man down, Martial, we were playing a group of three midfielders saath mein. You know, that thing needs to be there. Ki jahan beech mein Fernandes on your left, you have Van de Beek, or right Pogba, ya fir Matic hai ya kuch hai. You need to do that. This is a traditional way that United have been playing, with four defenders, two defensive midfielders, and one attacking midfielder, two wingers on his side. I think you need to change this tactic, because you cannot fit in Van de Beek in that. And that guy is a gem. He needs to start more often.
Right.
Even if it is instead of Pogba.
Yeah. You know, Vishesh, I want to come to you. You know, if you switch the formation, you've got some new signings in, right? Of course, we've got the likes of Edinson Cavani in. So now my question is, do you see us switching to a 4-4-2 diamond?
Guys, I was just going to come to that. I see two possible formations. One is a 3-5-2 and one is a 4-4-2 diamond. The reason I say 3-5-2 is Alex Telles is a way more attacking player in comparison to Luke Shaw. And Brandon Williams is way more attacking in comparison to Aaron Wan-Bissaka. So if we create a back three of, let's say, Eric Bailly, Harry Maguire, and Aaron Wan-Bissaka as a centre-back. Just hear me out. Centre-back on the left. With Brandon Williams as a wing-back and Alex Telles as a wing-back, we have three centre-backs who know how to defend and two wing-backs who can cross the ball well into the box. Agreed?
Okay, but Vishesh, in this, who's your midfield?
So that's where the confusion lies. Now, when we look at the midfield, we're going for a 3-5-2, right? Up front, I would play both Cavani and Martial, because we need that holding up striker, right? So that leaves us with how many players? Three more players to play up front, right? So
players in the field.
Yeah. So when it comes to that, is where the confusion lies, because we have to play Bruno, right? So Bruno behind the strikers, and then it would probably be Matic and. If, I mean, Pogba is not going to get dropped, so I would say Fred. Yeah. That would be a 3-5-2 formation if you want to go around with it. But yeah, the 4-4-2 also makes sense. But then you play Pogba and Van de Beek together in the diamond on the sides with Bruno up front.
Right. Manan, do you agree with that? Do you think that is something we can explore going forward, especially in a Champions League game? Because now those fixtures are also coming. Do you think is that something we can explore?
I agree with the 3-5-2 formation, but then the other one, I think 4-4-2 say better. I think we can go for 4-3-3, where the four defenders, you see the Barcelona false nine formation, right? It's where the Busquets is your only CDM and Xabi and Iniesta used to play as the attacking midfielders. And the defensive midfielder, he used to cover for the defenders and he used to supply the ball to both the midfielders up front. And then you have your main striker and two wingers with him. So I think Matic can be that CDM. And up front, you can either play Fernandes and Pogba or Fernandes and Van de Beek. And then in the front, you can have all your three forwards. I
Right.
see that happening pretty much.
But Manan, do you think now, see, we've mentioned all these formations, and these formations, and if you play a 3-5-2 or a 4-4-2, then Marcus Rashford has to sit out. So, Manan, do you think, we haven't spoken about him, he has been looking like he's improved. He's one player that's looking a little sharper than he was before, than the season, when the season began. A, do you let Marcus Rashford sit out? And B, is Edinson Cavani a starter for you? Forget the Martial red card for a minute. Is Edinson Cavani a starter for you?
Look, I think in 4-3-3, Cavani can definitely start with Martial on the left and Rashford on the right because Rashford has played on right wings. Martial, on the other hand, cannot play on right wing because he needs to cut. And Rashford can because Rashford gives in good supplies. He can even do the one touch and go blasting inside like he did against Luton. The moment he came, he just one touch with Greenwood and he was in. Rashford can do that. On the right or Greenwood, I don't think we will bench Rashford. Even if you bench Cavani for once and play the traditional what we play, Martial, Greenwood and Rashford, we can play that. But if Cavani starts, I don't think we can bench Rashford because he's in a good form.
Right. Vishesh, you know, I want to come to
I
you
can
on
see
this
Martial
one.
dropping to left.
Interesting. You know, this is what I want to come to. Manan and you both have mentioned so many varying formations. So does the inclusion of Cavani actually give us this versatility where Ole can no more be one-dimensional? Like that cannot be an excuse anymore for him.
It's not
No,
just
of course.
it's not just Cavani, Prasham. It's Alex Telles as well. That these two players is what will give Ole that, you know, the need of, and not even the need, the I give him the allowance to use a different formation. Because Luke Shaw stopped making those underlying and overlapping runs. Alex Telles will allow whoever the winger is to, you know, move inside and drag a player out. Cavani can head the ball. Martial isn't a header. Cavani can idly do what Ighalo does just 100 times better. His hold-up play, his involvement is way better than Ighalo. I do know that we're, you know, hyping Cavani for success at United, but if he can do even half of what he does as a, on a season basis in at PSG, I accept that. So Ole does not have any excuse now to say that, you know, and not even, yeah, he doesn't have an excuse now to show a one-dimensional team. He has the players to you know, do different tactical moves. So why not do so?
You know, Manan, this brings me to my final question of, you know, today is that obviously for Champions League and Premier League, we have to challenge for both. There's no question.
Of course,
We have
of course.
a few players, especially Telles, Van de Beek, and Cavani. These three players can add a different dimension to a team. We can try varied tactics. 3-5-2, we've spoken about a 4-4-2 diamond, a 4-3-3 with a false nine. My only problem with that is Matic doesn't have the legs that Busquets had, but that also is another issue. One or two games we can play in that way. So my last question to you is that looking at the squad depth, because now Van de Beek looks like he's not a first team player for some reason. We've got the Felistrati, or however you pronounce his name, from Uruguay as well.
Electric.
Amad Traore is coming in January. Do you think we should give the Carabao Cup and the FA Cup also a good run?
Of course, there is no excuse. I mean, look, we were crying out for a squad depth. I mean, of course, we had our main targets also in sight. Alex Telles is one of the main targets because we were looking for a left back. We saw very well last season that we cannot rely on Brandon Williams. On the other hand, Fosu Mensah showed some good touches in the attack. So, for once, I can let the right back slip because Aaron Wan-Bissaka doesn't get injured easily. He was not injured the whole time last season. So, our right wing is done, but we definitely needed a left wing. So, that for us is the main part. Then, other than Sancho, people stop concentrating that Martial isn't a proper striker. I have been crying out for this thing the whole last season. Martial, for all the form he had, for all the goals he scored, 23 goals, he is still not a proper striker. You cannot expect him to be.
I think Manan, he's a proper striker. He's not a proper center forward.
Well, I don't know. I think I consider him still more of a more as a winger. For me, he's still more as a winger who comes from the wings and drifts inside and then has a good finishing ability. I don't see him heading the ball. I don't see him inside the 6 yard box as often as a striker should be. I have never seen a poacher's goal from him as we saw from Lukaku. I mean, for all the criticism we gave him, that guy was there for every spilled ball, for every second ball. He was there in the box to score. We have not had that
Right.
poacher's effort from any striker. We didn't have a definite striker. Edinson Cavani,
Right.
for his age, but for his stature, he's a good striker. I mean, even if you keep him on the bench, that will increase the value of our bench. We should go for all the silverwares available this season, especially the domestic ones. Because Amad Traore, I've been seeing his videos since yesterday. He is one hell of a player. I mean, he has everything. He has dribbles, he has pace, he has finishing. Pelistri, I think he's not a well-cultivated player yet. We should send him to under-23s. He should not be there in the first team because he's nowhere near a complete product, just like Dan James.
Right.
He runs, he
Vishesh.
dribbles, but there's no finishing.
Right. Vishesh, now let's come to the final thing. We've seen four games. We've seen three games and two in the cups. We've seen five games actually. What do you think our prediction in the table is going to be? How far do we get in the Carabao Cup and FA Cup and in the Champions League? Just don't explain, just tell me what you feel.
Yeah, I just want to say one thing, Prasham. When
Yeah.
we started the full Premier League, roundup before the thing, Priyan and I came out and I said that United will finish second. I'm sorry for that. We're nowhere close to second with this squad.
Yeah.
But that being said, I think when it comes to the league, it'll be a tough fight for fourth. I don't even see us finishing third currently with how other sides are. I think fourth would be an achievement with this side. Again,
Okay.
and you talk about Carabao and FA Cup. I think we can go to the final in both. We have the squad depth to do that. Ole needs a trophy. He knows that if he gets like fourth and a trophy, he's good for another season. He's got himself another year, so I think he'll go for that. And with the group that we have, if Cavani is actually just signed for United to beat PSG, maybe like round of 16.
Okay, fair enough. Manan, do you agree with Vishesh or do you think our league position will be higher? We'll get knocked out quicker? What do you think?
I'm going to be a little more optimistic given the fact that this was the very team that got us from eighth position to third position where no one expected. This was the team that got us to three semi-finals. And now we have added a bit more quality to that team. I think, look, I'm not saying that the miracle that happened after Bruno came needs to happen because now Bruno has settled in well. Van de Beek has settled in well. I think so far, only our defense has let us down because attack, I still didn't see any problem. I mean, there were a few, rusted legs, lack in sharpnessness, but then I don't think that's the issue anymore because after Brighton game in the league, Brighton game in the Carabao Cup, and the way we were attacking in the Spurs game, even till the first 10, 15 minutes before the game got out of our hands, it was quite good. Only the defense was the problem. I think if we can get our defense sorted, we can probably finish in the top four again, and we can definitely get a silverware. Champions League, I see us going at least till quarterfinals. Carabao Cup and FA Cup, I am rooting at least go to the finals. Win the Carabao Cup, go to the finals of FA Cup. It can be a huge success for Ole. I'm being a bit optimistic here given what I saw after the restart.
So guys, you've heard it from us. We've broken down as to what the main problem areas have been. Individual errors, a few tactical mistakes and holes that have been there in the team that have probably existed from last season. Mentality has been lacking from the players, and I'm even going to put Ole's name in this because mentality is a big thing that comes from the manager as well. So I'm going to put Ole in as well in this. And now, after that, we've gone on to say that, we've got the players and shown them how tactically they can play different roles and positions. And now there is no excuse to not make a run. yes, we didn't get the players we wanted, but we yet have few players who can add to the depth, who give us a different option while playing. So there are players. Now it's time to focus on the football. There has been enough talk. The Glazers out, Woodward out is going to continue forever till they don't leave this club. But now it's time for the players to take the bull by its horns, get on the pitch and perform the way they do. Thanks for watching, guys. Do follow Mananveer Singh, his Instagram, his YouTube, and his songs on all platforms. We've put the links in the description. So good to have you here, Manan. Thanks, Vishesh, for
Thank you
joining.
so much.
Like the video and subscribe to the channel. See you all soon, guys.
See you, man.